day, loves. Today I'm going to give you a not-so-short tutorial on how to make a Lee Harvey Oswald doll, just like this one. First of all, you need a character figure named Lord Asriel from The Golden Compass. It's a movie, I didn't see it. Made by the Tonner Company, but you know what? They discontinued them in 2008, so good luck finding one. I got mine on the secondary market. And making an investment like this, I better be able to make a fairly decent likeness of Lee Harvey Oswald as I see him. Notice that disclaimer, as I see him. Let's get started. My other little Lee is looking on a bit apprehensively, because he doesn't know yet that he's going to be cloned. And here we go, the Golden Compass. I'm sure all of you have seen this movie except me. Here's how he comes. Oh, now, obviously I caught Lee after he was kind of partying hardy the other night, and he is not liking this. I don't blame him, because he's going to be your clone in a little bit. He's going to be your clone. What do you think of that? It'll be okay. He's gonna be nice, just like you. Oh, he doesn't like that.
Okay, this is one of the more horrifying aspects of starting a Lee Harvey Oswald doll. I don't really use all of those tools, but at some point I do.
Namely, the awl, to begin with. Because as you can see, this guy is smooth, like a twink, like a kid. And if he's gonna look like a man, he's gonna have to have secondary sex characteristics. And this is the way I initially established them, is by carving. And using the awl, what I'm doing is actually carving grooves in here. You can see this is going to be his chest hair. It looks hard, and it is hard, because these things are hard vinyl. It takes a lot to do this. And if you think this is hard, wait till I get to the legs.
I remember when I got my first Lee Oswald prototype, I had to call this store in New Jersey. Got this lady, I told her exactly what I was going to do with it. And she said, "Oh my god!" I thought, "Oh great, I've offended her." She said, "Oh my god, that doll does look like Lee Harvey Oswald! Sheila, doesn't this doll look just like Lee Harvey Oswald?" I was so delighted that she could see it too.
Right. So, basically I'm not pushing down too hard with the brush, but I'm just covering the whole area, because it's not going to look this dark once I brush it off with my fingers. Okay. Now, I am rubbing that in. I am pushing it into those grooves and channels. It takes work. Now, I'm going to rub off the excess, and you see how it just leaves a little bit there. Some of it I can take off with my hand. Really hard. I mean, really jamming that in there. It's making a mess, but we're going to wipe that away with the toilet paper. I guess anything could be used, a swab or something, but toilet paper is handy when you're doing this in the John, as I am. And there, he's got a treasure trail. In his stocking feet or something. Also, see these grooves where the doll company has manufactured toes? Those grooves are great, like the toenails and all, but too often they don't show up because they're all one color. So I like to fill that in with the color and then just whoop, brush over it, and that helps them stand out a little bit more. You know? And the bottoms of the feet, again, they have some subtle indentions there, but I'm just going to bring them out a little bit. I'm using a raw umber. Not that the soles of his feet are ever going to be seen in any of my projects, or any of my exhibits, or what have you. By the way, there is a Lee Harvey Oswald doll of mine just like this one touring in a show called The People's Biennial. You might want to look it up. It might be in your town. It's going to be touring for 2 years. It goes to Pennsylvania, Winston-Salem, somewhere in South Dakota, back to Phoenix, Portland, Oregon. So, and a doll just like this is represented in the show. And that's why I'm making another one, is because I'm afraid if he gets damaged to the chest. And I know you're all wondering what I did with his junk down there. Of course you're wondering, but I'm not going to tell you. This one, I really rubbed the paint into, and it just doesn't show up enough for my liking. And yeah, people say you could draw it on with a Sharpie, you could, you know, there's other ways of doing it, why don't you just paint it on? The problem is Sharpie will bleed into the plastic, and paint it on will just rub off with the friction of putting clothes on them and such. The paint in the channels is really what will stay there forever. So, okay, this is by far the scariest aspect. Scarier and harder and more intimidating than doing the face paint alone is doing the hair. Because I do not know how to dye doll hair. This isn't a wig that will come off, so I have to paint it. So it's like I color it and run water through it to keep it hair-like. It's going to take a while before I get it dark brown enough to be Lee. So here. So this is very, very intimidating. And then just to just glob in there. And it's a very harrowing experience because you got to do it quick because I don't want the paint to clot. This mustache brush I can actually use to comb through his hair, to comb the paint through it. Obviously, I go through a lot of those. Oh. Okay. Right now, he is drying. He's resting.
Okay, it's the next day, the next evening, actually, and I'm ready to do the face paint.
Copying from the other figure as best I can.
Deep under the hairs, I can't. You know, I found out last night this hair does come off. You have to really peel at it and not glue it back on, but it does come off. But it's getting there a little bit. Like I said, when I get that shaver shadow in there, should not lighten that again.
Veins on his hands. Then we tamp.
What did I do? I stepped in the paint water. That is why we keep paper towels around.
A little bit of extra bearding I can do here. Just the tiniest dab of turquoise in there gives him those slightly killer baby blues, no pun intended.
Lee did not wear lip gloss, but it just adds a little human aspect to any figure. Of course, my original Lee Harvey is the super macho Lee Harvey, and I'm not going to be doing that with this doll, but I'll just give you an example of how I would do it. I use this, which you can get at hobby and craft stores, and it already comes in nice curly little locks, black, and I've just kind of scumbled it around like this and separated some of the curls and made it into kind of a thatch, and this is going to be his little tuft of chest hair. And here he is down here awaiting his procedure. See how he looks kind of sad? I like it when the expressions can change. The hot glue gun is heating up. Yes, hot glue process. All it is simply dabbing some light dots, just some light little spots on the chest, and quick, picking up that thatch and tamping it down.
Ow.
I am using these lame little fingertip protectors. I usually forget to, and it hurts. It hurts him more than me, I'm sure, but it helps in case I have him wearing an open collar shirt just to have that little bit sticking out, doesn't it? And you're done! You are done, man! You are done! Let's get you dressed.
Well, now looking good, Mr. Lee Oswald clone. Huh. Very nice. You could learn a thing or two from him. Or not. Because I like you just the way you are.
Ah, and so another dashing, handsome, Lee Harvey to join the other little and not so little Lee Oswalds. So, thank you for tuning in, loves. Now, are you two going to get along, or are there going to be jealousy issues since you two are so very similar? Huh? Huh? You'd be good.
You'd be good.
You'd be good.